Hi, it's Lenneke from Lenscrafty Life, and I finally made it back to our new home. Look at that beautiful tree there. It's the end of May now and it flowers till October. It's really pretty, and a lot of the garden is blossoming and green. And these are new stones that we're gonna use to enlarge the terrace. This is gonna go, and I'm gonna put a very nice cast iron tea set over there, which I will show you because I've already picked it up, got it from Marktplaats, so second hand. That's the kitchen window, and this is my new craft room to be. It's a converted garage. Now, you may know that for the last 6 weeks I haven't been able to go here because I had a very intense rash because of this beautiful floor that was treated with a natural oil, but there were some chemical compounds in it, and I reacted to that very, very strongly. So today is a tryout. Hopefully I won't get the rash again. And these are my belly bookcases. I've already started putting something in. Let me just switch on the light, which is this one, and I think it's that one. I just have to figure out, and I've got some lights up. Yay! My chandeliers, they had to be shortened. It could be done. I'm not sure if I'm happy with these results. Of course, I have to put in some extra lamps. There's a few lamps missing. I couldn't, the shop had run out, so I have to put in some more. I'm not sure if I like this, if I think it's too tight to the ceiling. The ceiling is very low here. We've had those beautiful rosettes put in. And so I'm not sure. But this one is going to be above a craft table. There will be two craft tables of about 4 meters, 4.5 yards in the middle, which is this table, which you can hardly see. And that table, I'm painting them white, they'll be in the middle. And literally, I've just come in, I picked up these 4 chairs. Now, obviously, you can see there's stains on them. They're again secondhand. Everything you see in this room is secondhand. There's nothing new. So I will have these reupholstered. So I may try myself. The idea is that they will be white. The wood will be white, the wooden frame. And I want to put in some white creamy fabric with soft pink roses. If I can find affordable fabric. I already found some beautiful, beautiful fabric, but it was incredibly expensive, so I have to find something else. Now, I've already started to put in some books. So books and papers will go in here, and I'm the very proud owner of a lot of these. It's the, I do have an English version as well. Well, I thought you may recognize this. It's the Edith Holden diary, De Vreugde van het Landleven. It's called in Dutch. And these are larger ones. A diary of an English lady from 1906, it says. So these are all in Dutch. I picked them up all secondhand, of course, from Marktplaats or secondhand bookshops. Lots of old books here. Music books, those are craft magazines. That's a very cute Beatrix Potter, Hunka Munka and her babies. And this one looks like my eldest daughter, who is now 18, but I got it when she was little and I absolutely loved it because it made me think of her. And this one, this painting, it's a real painting. It has not been signed, so no idea who the artist is, but I think I will hang this in my garden she shed. It's very beautiful. So a quick tour of my big mess. You may have seen in my last video my bedroom in my old house where we still live now, which is a 1.5 hours drive away, and it's going up for sale this week. It should be on Wednesday on Funda, if you know it. That's a Dutch site. And I'm gonna style it this week. It has been styled already for the photo, so I will do a non-craft room turned into bedroom again tour. Because you may have seen my craft room tour, it was full with all this stuff. And you can see, this is a converted garage. It's a very large room, at least I think it is. And all this stuff was in my bedroom, haha, slash craft room. So that's my last Billy bookcase going in there. My craft desk will be here. The idea is there will be a window over here put in, hopefully in August, because we've run out of money at the moment. Need to save up. And then this is onto the garden. So that room, it will be a standing desk. That not room, that window will overlook the garden. And this is the cast iron tea set that I picked up on the last day I was here, about 6 weeks ago. And this set will go in front of my craft room. And just look at this garden. Isn't it stunning? Now that's my garden she shed. That is the she shed of my daughter. It's been painted white, but there's just stuff in there. It's not been decorated yet, so I will do an update of that when that's done. That's a little shed which will be the workout shed of my husband. And I just love this garden. And just listen to the birds. Isn't that amazing? I love it. And look at this beautiful soft pink rhododendron. And there's a purple one. There's a soft pink one. That's an Acer, which turns bright red in autumn. And I'll just briefly pan to the right. This is a pond that we're taking out. So that will be more garden. And over here, I hope to do a vegetable patch. And the grass is very tall. Beautiful red poppy I've got over there. Some very large trees over here. That's our bedroom. We'll probably have to take off the climbing, what do you call it? This stuff. Nah, lost for words. But it may be okay. I just have to some really suck into your wall, which ruins your house, and you can get leakages. How do you say that's not the pub word either, is it? Lost for words here. And this looks like a vine, by the way. Maybe it is a vine, not sure. Oh, hi. Hi there. So anyway, let's go in here. Back into the craft room, my beautiful cast iron mat that I've just put down. And so I just wanted to show you the cast iron set that I'm gonna put in the front, which is over there. And all this stuff needs to be sorted out. Ta-da-ta-ta. So I will be back this week if I don't get a rash tonight, which I reckon I won't. This will be my sewing desk, which is the last desk that is still in my current bedroom. And these are PAX wardrobes for my very large boxes. This is my other white desk. I think I'm gonna make this my cutting station. So with my big shots and all that kind of stuff. Well, there you go. There's Christmas stuff in that old, very old bookcase. So there you go. I won't go through it all now. I'll make you dizzy. A lot of stuff to do over here. And that's to the kitchen. The kitchen will be placed in about a month. They managed to, this is a new, this was heightened, the bar, and this was painted white. I'll briefly show you the kitchen again, because there's a lot of stuff in here as well. That's a filing cabinet which still needs to go in there. This is another dresser with a top which will go over here on this wall. So a lot to do. That's a blue cupboard which will go into the living room, which I still need to paint white. And this all has to be out. That's my dehydrator, because I am into healthy foods too. And the kitchen will be placed within about a month. Now, these doors officially have to go on that last Billy bookcase, which will be right behind my standing desk over there in the corner. It's already there, but there's not enough space to open the door, so I'll have to leave those off, and I'll probably put like a little curtain, because as you can see, I've got doors on everything, sliding doors on the PEX wardrobes, doors on these bookcases, and behind the glass I will put some pretty wallpaper so that you cannot look in to these wardrobes, because the point is that not only do I want to give crafty workshops here, we're also going to do Bible studies here and prayer days and things like that. So then it has a different purpose, this room. Then it's not a craft room, even though it is. But I need to keep it tidy. Can you imagine that? If you've seen my previous craft room video, I'm not the tidiest person in the world. So that will be a real challenge for me, but I'm gonna do it. Beautiful. I think I do like it. It's a bit odd. Just let me think. What do you think? Should I leave these chandeliers there, or do they look odd because they are so close to the ceiling? I can't really put them much lower. Because, well, this one will be above one of the tables, but that one you need to be able to walk underneath. So, well, let me know what you think. Should I go for something else, or do you think it's okay? I think I think it will grow on me. Anyway, there you go. Lots of stuff. This is all you see here in boxes is indeed craft stuff. Yes, it is. So, anyway, there you go. I'll leave you to it and me to it. And I hope to see you again in my next video. So thanks for watching. Bye-bye.